I have had enough of McDonald's and this one childhood incident to be blamed for it. I was in middle school when my mom married a man from her workplace. They dated for a year and suddenly decided to tie the knot. I never knew my dad. My mom single-handedly raised me and my little sister, Jenny. I wasn't very happy with the idea of having a stepdad in our family. Even though this guy named David was fun-loving, I always felt weird around him. Even though he beguiled my mom and Jenny with his innocent face, I knew there was something evil lurking inside of that man. Anyways, after a small marriage ceremony, David officially became a member of our family. Even though Jenny got mixed up with him easily, I kept my distance. I always watched his every single action, silently looking for one red flag. I was playing in the backyard one day, and he came to me. "What's up, Alex? Can I play with you?" I didn't reply, and just sat quietly. "Look, Alex, I know you don't see me as your father, but we can be friends. You gotta give me a chance, man." I felt a bit bad for being so hard on him, so I said, "Okay, we can be friends." "Great. How about we go to lunch today? Mom has to go to work, so you, me, and Jenny. It'll be fun." "Okay, let's go." I saw a smile on my mom's face once she came to know that I had agreed to go to lunch with David. She might have felt relieved, thinking finally we were getting along. David took us to the mall. He bought us toys and took us to the gaming section. Jenny and I had fun that afternoon. When it was time to go for lunch, David took us to McDonald's. We ate burgers with lots of fries and came home. After that day, whenever we ordered food or went out to eat, David always took us to McDonald's. It started to feel freakishly weird after a certain point in time. Sometimes, for breakfast, he would get sausages and muffins from McDonald's. For lunch, he would order a bacon double cheeseburger. And most weekends, he ate his favorite meal, a Big Mac and fries. He enjoyed the food, no doubt. Whenever I saw him munching the burger, I felt kind of creeped out. He used to take big bites while staring at us in a very freaky way. It was as if he was not only eating with his mouth, but also with his hungry eyes. After a point, we three couldn't put up with his obsession with McDonald's. I couldn't bear the sight of a McDonald's burger. Eventually, we started avoiding eating at McDonald's, but David didn't take it in a good way. He started behaving like a completely different person, as if we had betrayed him in some way. One night, my mom wanted to order food from a local Chinese restaurant. David immediately got furious and said, "But why not McDonald's? We all eat from McDonald's."
"David, I think we've had enough McDonald's food. The kids want to try something else now."
"Yeah, right.
Why don't you be honest with me?"
"Honest about what?"
"That they are sick and tired of their stepdad, and you all don't want to eat with me anymore. You all want to kick me out of this family, right?"
He stormed out in his car and didn't return for 2 days. My mom kept calling him, but David didn't respond. One Saturday evening, David came back. He was looking wicked, like he hadn't slept in a really long time. His eyes were puffy, and his hair was disheveled. He brought burgers and fries from McDonald's and ate alone sitting at the kitchen table while giving us that same creepy stare. We all had dinner and went to our rooms to sleep. David slept on the living room couch, and my mom was too tired to pick up another fight with him. She decided to comfort him in the morning about his weird behavior and take final action. Jenny and I slept in the big bedroom, right beside the living room. I don't exactly remember what time it was, but I heard our bedroom door creak open. The light peered in from the hallway, and I could see a figure standing near our bedroom door. I could tell it was a man, but his face was completely shrouded in darkness. Jenny was scared of the darkness, so we had a small table lamp lit in our room at night. As soon as the man stepped into our room, I recognized him. I blinked my eyes in surprise. It was Ronald McDonald. He was just standing there silently and staring at us. He didn't seem to be aware that I was awake. In the dim light, he crept into our room and tiptoed quietly over to Jenny's bed. From where I was laying, I could see him reach out and grab my sister with his strong hands. Then all of a sudden, he started to shake her violently, saying, "I'm loving it! I'm loving it!" My sister started to scream, and I hit the lights immediately. As I got close to look at the face, I realized it was David, dressed as Ronald McDonald and scaring my sister. He didn't seem to be bothered at all by the lights or me witnessing him doing this. He just kept screaming,
"I'm loving it!"
"Let go of my sister, you freak!" My mom came rushing from upstairs, hearing my sister and me screaming in the middle of the night. From the doorway, I heard my mother's voice cry out in alarm.
"What the hell are you doing?"
He quickly released my sister and ran towards the big glass window in our room. Shattering those glass pieces, David fell on the hard ground. Even though it was a ground floor window, I saw broken glass piercing his face, creating a bloody mess. He then stood outside the window and stared right at us. Jenny and I hugged Mom tightly and started to sob in fear. She couldn't believe her eyes. Needless to say, seeing David that way gave her a hell of a shock. David gave us an ear-to-ear smile and said,
"How can you not love McDonald's? 'Cause I am definitely loving it."
He then ran away while laughing like a crazy psycho. My mom filed a restraining order against him. I don't know what he would have done to us if my mom wasn't home that night. It took months for my sister to come out of the trauma of that night, and we eventually went on with our lives. My mom filed for divorce as well, and after David, she still hasn't dated any other guy. I know somewhere deep down, she thinks it all happened because she brought David into the family. I don't know where David is now, and I don't want to know. David, if you're watching this, I dare you to come near us now, because I am quite capable.